In Julia, a comprehension is a shorthand way of constructing an array. The subject of comprehensions really should have been covered in the chapter on arrays. But you need to know how to use a for loop before you can use a comprehension, which is why I'm covering it now. Here's the syntax for a comprehension. Like any other array, the elements are placed in between a pair of square brackets. But rather than inserting individual elements, you use a for loop to populate your array. The expression can be something simple, like the numbers in the range. Or it can be something more sophisticated, like an equation that uses the numbers in the range as inputs. Following the expression is the header of the for loop. So it's just the keyword for, followed by a variable name, the equal sign character, and then the range object. When using a comprehension, there is no need to use the keyword end. Let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code, and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. In addition, I've docked my REPL window next to my editor. Now before hitting Shift-Enter, let's talk about this code. In this example, I to the third power is the expression. I is the variable name for the numbers in the range object. And 1:10 is the range object, meaning the integers from 1 to 10, inclusive. So the expression is the task that your computer will repeat using each number in the range. Your computer will place the results of these calculations inside of an array. Now hit Shift-Enter to see what happens. In the REPL, you'll see a display of a 10-element vector with elements of type int64. Recall that a vector in Julia is just an alias for a one-dimensional array. The value of each element is the number in the range raised to the power of 3. Pretty cool, right? You can index this array just like any other array. So the 7th element in this array has a value of 343, which is the same as 7 cubed. Fun, right? So that's the basics of using a comprehension in Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn what a function is and how to use it in Julia.